Hello everyone. So last class I discussed about gradient descent and the delta rule, and also I discussed about visualizing the hypothesis space, so which were the very important concepts with respect to perceptron. So in today's class I am going to discuss derivation of the gradient descent rule. So this is also very important. In your examination he may ask you to give the derivation of the gradient descent rule. Here, how can we calculate the direction of steepest descent along with the error surface? So that is what one question in front of us. So this direction can be found by computing the derivative of capital E with respect to each component of vector W bar. Right? So this vector derivative or this vector derivative is called as gradient of E with respect to vector W, that is the W vector, which is written like this, that is delta negation. So this is negation of delta, something like that, because this symbol looks like the opposite to delta, right? So this E of W vector is equal to, this is also you can consider as a delta here. So this is a type of delta here, right? So the symbol E of W vector is equivalent to delta E divided by delta W naught, comma delta E divided by delta W1, comma delta E divided by W2, and so on up to delta E divided by delta Wn. Here you can notice that this particular parameter, that is a delta E of W vector, is itself is a vector, means this particular component, this parameter itself is a vector. So whose components are the partial derivatives of capital E with respect to each of Wi. So when interpreted as a vector in weight space, the gradient specifies the direction that produces the steepest increase in capital E. Here the negative of this vector therefore gives the direction of steepest decrease. That's why I told this is a kind of negative symbol here. So this negative of this vector means this indicates the negativity, right? So the negative of this vector gives the direction of steepest decrease. That is important. Since the gradient specifies the direction of steepest increase of capital E, the training rule for gradient descent is given as W vector is equal to W vector plus delta W vector. So this is the training rule for the gradient descent, where delta W vector is equal to minus n of this negative parameter, that is E of W vector. Right here, you can call it as some n symbol here. So this symbol is a positive constant. You can see this symbol. So this symbol is a positive constant, and it is called as the learning rate, which determines the step size in the gradient descent search. And the negative sign is present because we want to move the weight vector in the direction that decrease E. Why we have taken a negative sign is, this negative sign is present because we want to move the weight vector in the direction that decreases capital E. So this training rule can also be written in its component form like this, that is a W vector is equal to W vector plus delta W vector. In this case, delta W vector is equal to negation of n delta E divided by delta Wi. So which makes it clear that the steepest descent is achieved by altering each component Wi of W vector in proportion of delta E divided by delta Wi. Kindly note down these steps one by one. Now to construct a partial algorithm for iteratively updating the weights according to the previous equation, that is according to equation 5. We need an efficient way of calculating the gradient at each step. Fortunately, this is not difficult here. Here, the vector of delta E divided by delta W I derivates that the form that gradient can be obtained by differentiating capital E from the previous equations. Here, kindly note down these derivative steps. Delta E divided by delta W I is equal to delta divided by delta W I, and E I am substituting from one of the previous equation, that is 1 by 2 summation of TD minus OD square, and it simplifies to like this: 1 by 2 summation delta by delta I TD minus OD square. Further, it is simplifies to 2 times I have taken this, right? So further it is simplifies to like this. So finally we got the equation as delta E divided by delta W I is equal to summation TD minus OD into minus XI comma D in the range of D. So here I am substituting equation 6 into equation 5. So this is equation 5, right? So substituting equation 6 into equation 5, it will yield the weight update rule for the gradient descent as delta WI is equal to n of summation TD minus OD into XID, where small d belongs to capital D. Capital D indicates the set of training examples, where small d indicates a particular training example. So these are what the different derivative steps, which will represent the weight update rule for the gradient descent. Next comes the important algorithm, that is a gradient descent algorithm for training a linear unit. Here you have to remember the different steps of this algorithm. So gradient descent of training examples, comma n. So these are what the two inputs I am passing to this algorithm, gradient descent algorithm, right? Here each training example is a pair of the form x vector comma t, where x vector is the vector of input values and small t is the target output value, and n is the learning rate that we know, right? N can be assigned with 0.0 by 0.07, something like that. Here initialize each wi to some small random rule, then continue the step until the termination condition is met. So we have to perform these following steps until the termination condition is met. So the steps to be performed are: initialize each delta wi to 0, then for each x vector comma t in training example, perform input the instance x vector to the unit and compute the output o, then for each linear unit weight wi, perform delta wi is equal to delta wi plus n of t minus o xi, then for each linear unit weight wi, perform wi is equal to wi plus delta wi. So these steps you have to perform until the termination condition is met. So this is what the gradient descent algorithm for training a linear unit. Then to summarize, the gradient descent algorithm for training linear units is as follows. First, pick an initial random weight vector, then apply the linear unit to all the training examples, then compute delta wi for each weight according to the previous equation, means according to this equation, that is according to the weight update equation. Then update each weight wi by adding delta wi, then repeats this process. So this algorithm is given in terms of a table. You can mention, or you can mention the result of this algorithm in the form of a table. Here, because the error surface contains only a single global minimum, So this algorithm will converge to a weight vector with minimum error, irrespective of whether the training examples are linearly separable or not. Given a sufficiently small learning rate, n is used. If n is too large, then gradient descent search runs the risk of overstepping the minimum in the error surface rather than settling into it. And for this reason, one common modification to this algorithm is to gradually reduce the value of n as the number of gradient descent step increases. So this is just a summary of this gradient descent algorithm for training learning units or linear units. Then I have specified some of the features of gradient descent algorithm. Here, gradient descent is an important general paradigm for learning, and it is a strategy for searching through a large or a infinite hypothesis space that can be applied whenever you want. Here I have noted two important points. One is the hypothesis space contains continuously parameterized hypothesis. Second one is the error can be differentiated with respect to these hypothesis parameters. Then next, the key practical difficulties in applying the gradient descent are some challenges in applying the gradient descent are. First one, converging to a local minimum can sometimes be quite slow. And second challenge is, if there are multiple local minima in the error surface, then there is no guarantee that the procedure will find the global minimum. So these are the two difficulties or challenges in applying the gradient descent algorithm. So this is about the today's discussion. So in the next class, I am going to discuss the very next important concept, that is the stochastic approximation to gradient descent. Thank you.